والإسلام ديني ومحمدا رسول الله
ويقيني. One of the obligations imposed by Allah upon His servants is prayer, Salah. Salah was ordained during the night of the Isra, 1 year before the Hijra. In essence, the originally mandated number of daily prayers was 50 times, but after the request of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, for leniency from his Lord, the number of daily prayers was reduced to 5 times a day, far, dawn, dur, noon, asar, afternoon, maghrib, sunset, and isha, night. After receiving the command to pray, the angel Gabriel was sent to teach the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, how to perform the prayers. One of the essential aspects of performing prayer, salah, is to face the Qibla. Before the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, migrated to Medina, the obligatory direction to face during prayer was initially towards the Al-Aqsa Mosque in Jerusalem, which was the first Qibla in Islam. However, after the Prophet's migration to Medina with his companions, the Qibla was redirected towards the Kaaba in Mecca. The event of changing the Qibla was a significant moment in Islam. It occurred during the month of Rajab, 2 months before the Battle of Badr. While the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and his companions were performing the Dur prayer in the Mosque of Banu Sulaymah, now known as the Mosque of the Two Qiblas, they initially faced Al-Aqsa in the first two units, Rak'ah, of prayer and then turned their direction to the Masjid Al-Haram, Kaaba, in Mecca for the remaining units, Rak'ah. Before the change of the Qibla, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, himself had hoped for this change and even, according to one narration, negotiated with Gabriel, continually raising his face to the sky in the hope that his wish would be granted by the Creator. This event is immortalized in the Quran in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 144. Indeed, we see you, O Prophet, turning your face towards heaven. Now we will make you turn towards a direction of prayer that will please you. So turn your face towards the sacred mosque in Mecca, wherever you are, turn your faces towards it. Those who were given the scripture certainly know this to be the truth from their Lord. And Allah is never unaware of what they do. In the book Ra'i al-Bayan by Muhammad Ali al-Shabuni, it is explained that there were four factors that made the Prophet strongly desire to face the Kaaba and no longer the Al-Aqsa Mosque. 1. To differentiate from the Jews. The Jews used to face the Al-Aqsa Mosque in their prayers, and they taunted and ridiculed the Prophet Muhammad when he prayed while still facing the same direction. They would say, "Muhammad is imitating us. If it weren't for us, he wouldn't know which way to face in his worship." This hurt the Prophet and motivated him to desire the change in the Qibla. 2. The Kaaba was the Qibla of Prophet Abraham. Since Prophet Ibrahim was the forefather of Prophet Muhammad, and the message he carried was essentially the message of Prophet Ibrahim, Prophet Muhammad wanted to restore the Qibla to the same direction as it was during the time of Prophet Ibrahim. 3. To attract the Arabs to Islam. 4. The Prophet Muhammad desired to face the Qibla of his homeland, which was the Kaaba. And Allah knows best. Hopefully, this is all useful.
ومحمدا رسول الله.